In this video, I'm going to show you how to perform the Dix Hallpike maneuver to diagnose benign paroxysmal positional vertigo from the posterior semicircular canals. Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Benign paroxysmal positional vertigo, abbreviated as BPPV, is the most common in-ear problem and cause of vertigo or false sense of spinning. Common causes are head trauma or ear infections, although most cases appear to be idiopathic. BPPV can be caused by debris in the semicircular canal of the ear, which continues to move after the head has stopped moving. This causes ongoing movement that conflicts with other sensory information. The semicircular canals are filled with a fluid called endolymph. The main sense organ in each canal is called the crista, which is stimulated by movement of the cupula. Head movement causes relative movement of the endolymph in the semicircular canal, which bends the cupula and the embedded hairs of the hair cells and causes stimulation of the relevant vestibular nerve. The cause of BPPV is believed to be canalithiasis, affecting the posterior semicircular canal in 85 to 95% of all cases. In canalithiasis, free-floating debris in the semicircular canal is hypothesized to act like a plunger, causing continuing movement of the endolymph even after head movement has ceased. This causes movement of the cupula and bending of the hairs of the hair cells and provokes vertigo. Around 20% of BPPV cases are said to resolve within 4 weeks and up to 50% up to 3 months without treatment, but recurrence is reported between 10 to 18% after 1 year. The Dix Hallpike maneuver is considered a gold standard for the diagnosis of posterior canal BPPV. The lack of alternative external gold standards limits the availability of sensitivity and specificity data. As the Dix Hallpike maneuver is the best test we have and regarded as the gold standard, we are giving this test a high clinical value in practice. Before you conduct the test, the patient should be counseled that the symptoms of vertigo will be reproduced and that he might feel nauseous. So make sure you have a bucket at hand in case your patient might need it. To perform the Dix Hallpike test, have your patient sit on the treatment bench in long sit with a pillow on the table that will make sure that the patient's head is extended to 20 degrees in a second. Stand on the side to be examined and firmly hold your patient's head in 45 degrees of rotation towards the side to be tested. In this case, the right posterior semicircular canal of the patient is aligned with the sagittal plane. Instruct the patient to keep his eyes open and take the patient backwards in a quick movement so that your patient's head is still rotated and extended to 20 degrees by the pillow. Observe the patient's eyes for the latency, duration, and direction of the nystagmus. The nystagmus typically has a latency of around 5 to 20 seconds and fatigues within 60 seconds after onset. In a positive test, the patient will experience vertigo during this test. If the initial result is negative, the Dix Hallpike test should be repeated on the other side. If the nystagmus presented with a lateral beat or a downbeat, lateral or anterior BPPV should be suspected. On top of that, if you suspect BPPV in your patient and this maneuver is negative in both directions, you should assess the lateral canal with the supine head roll maneuver, for which you can find a video in the top right corner. The anterior canal is rarely affected with 1 to 3% of all BPPV cases, and its pathophysiology is poorly understood. In these cases, you should refer out to a specialist. Alright, this was our video on the Dix Hallpike maneuver for BPPV of the posterior canal. If you want to know how to treat this condition, make sure to watch our video on the Epley maneuver by a click on the video right next to me. At last, thank you very much for watching. Please click on the like button if you enjoyed this video, subscribe to our channel and turn on the notifications in order not to miss any new videos. This was Kai for Physiotutors. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.